Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. Today we are taking a look at a literal game changer on Steam Deck, a software that not only allows you to easily install third-party launchers, but also enables you to install games from these launchers on your SD card. And not only that, it even automatically scans for games installed via those launchers and adds them to your Steam Deck UI. That's right, we are talking about the NonSteamLaunchers project, which allows you to install, for example, your Epic Games launcher on Steam Deck and finally enjoy all those free games we keep getting every week. So, today we are going to talk about what this project is, how it works, and how you can install it. It's not that hard, but stick around until the end of the video to see how it works. Ready? Let's go! The NonSteamLaunchers project is basically a script that allows you to select all the launchers that exist right now, even including cloud gaming services like GeForce Now, Xbox Game Pass Cloud Streaming, as well as Amazon Luna. It automatically downloads and installs them, and while installing them, it also adds a service that always runs in the background to scan your games and automatically add them to Steam. That's right, no need to start your launcher through Steam and then start the games anymore. Just select your games and run them, just like I did with Assassin's Creed Odyssey for this video. Right now, it automatically adds games installed via Epic Games, Ubisoft Connect, the EA app, GOG Galaxy, Battle.net, as well as the Amazon Games app. All you need to do is install the script, but the games might need a reboot or a switch to desktop and back to appear in your Steam library. NonSteamLaunchers even adds custom artwork, so the games feel right at home in your Steam library. But some artworks might not be the best for this specific game, as it shows a non-English version for the cover art for my game. But that's easy to fix with a neat Steam Deck plugin called SteamGridDB. More about that in an upcoming video. Feel free to leave a sub so you don't miss it. By the way, after installing each launcher, NonSteamLaunchers also downloads the latest Proton version and applies it to your games, which is neat, but I highly recommend changing the Proton version to Experimental to get the latest performance enhancements right from Valve, especially for newer games. To do that, just go to your games or your launcher's properties, select Compatibility, if unticked, tick Force the use of a specific Steam Play compatibility tool and select Proton Experimental. This might increase the performance of some games, especially newer ones. If you're as curious as me, you might be wondering what the NonSteamLaunchers software actually does when adding the games to your Steam Deck. If you're not, just skip ahead to the installation tutorial. Still here? Alright. So, when searching and finding the games on your Steam Deck, all the background service does is add a shortcut to the launcher you're using, followed by a command to run a specific game ID. I needed to figure this out because, for some reason, the service did not detect my Assassin's Creed Odyssey installation. So what I did was copy the target, start in and launch options text fields from Prince of Persia The Lost Crown, then googled the app ID for AC Odyssey and pasted it into the launch options line at the end. This process should be the same for every other launcher, so in case it doesn't detect your games, this is how you can force it to. Alright, now comes the part where I tell you the grueling, complex, just unfathomable installation process. I'm gonna use my Bluetooth mouse and keyboard for this. By the way, if you have a wireless mouse on your PC, it might also have a Bluetooth toggle. Just a general recommendation. So, ready? First, switch to desktop mode on your Steam Deck. Launch the browser of your choice and head to the releases page of NonSteamLaunchers. The link is in the description. Download this .desktop file, drag it onto your desktop, and run it. Wait a couple seconds for the installation window to pop up and click the launchers you actually want. After clicking OK, you can even select specific websites to add them as apps to your Steam Deck. So if you want to install Threads, Amazon, or maybe even my YouTube channel as a specific website, this is where to put the link. Now you have to play the waiting game, as the script automatically downloads and installs the selected software to your Steam Deck and adds them to Steam. After the installation is finished, don't head back into gaming mode just yet. Stop the launcher in desktop mode first, as it might want to open a web browser first, and especially if you log in to some launchers with Google, the login screen might not trust the Steam Deck browser, so you might have to install Google Chrome or Microsoft Edge first, which you can both of course find in the Discover App Store. Once you're logged in, you can finally start installing games. NonSteamLaunchers allows you to install them to your SD card as well. To do that, all you have to do is change the installation folder location when installing games. Let's show how it works just for good measure. I'm using Ubisoft Connect for this example. Pick any game, hit download, continue, blah blah, and when Ubisoft asks for the folder location, hit change. This will open a clunky, old-school looking Explorer window where you can select your installation folder. Click the plus icon next to My Computer, then E. This is your SD card by default. Just create a new folder called Ubisoft Games, then select that folder and hit OK. Then progress with the installation as usual. That's it, all your non-Steam games can be installed this way. This is a literal godsend for the 64GB Steam Deck users. So, do you agree that this is a game changer for the Steam Deck? I certainly think so, as it completely removes the friction of running non-Steam launchers on the Steam Deck. Running non-Steam games just feels as easy as running any game on Steam after a few installation steps. And not only that, before using the software, you always had to start a launcher first, then start a game. This meant that if you set up a specific controller setting, it would be the same across all games started via Ubisoft Connect. And if you wanted to limit one game to 30 and another to 50, you'd have to switch back and forth every time because both had the same settings, since the Steam Deck ties settings to the software you just started, and to the Steam Deck you just started Ubisoft Connect and not Assassin's Creed. This is all fixed now, and while you could install on SD cards before by using a specific script, this software makes it so much easier. I simply adore this project, and if you love it as much as I do, consider showing your support by giving it a star on GitHub or buying its creator a coffee. Links are in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. If you are already subscribed, you might have noticed a change. We are now speaking English instead of German. My previous content partner has moved on, so I'm using this opportunity for a fresh start with a new Twitch channel, also linked in the description. While our videos are now in English, you can still enjoy German subtitles, of course. As soon as YouTube allows multiple audio tracks for my channel, I'll even consider offering English and German versions. Also, if you're living in the future, the video on the custom game art plugin should be right here. Until then, have a fantastic day and good luck with your endeavors. Look forward to seeing you again. Auf Wiedersehen.